This is our alternate step three option if we stop at the second one. And in this case, we're moving further from the load. So this distance that we're rotating and we're moving away from the load is longer. And so this is generally considered a non-optimum design because the matching circuit takes up more space. So here's our load. D is larger. So this, all this together is going to take, where we're going to put our, whatever our matching element is, it's going to take up more space. But at that location, we could use a capacitor, since we're on the other half of the Smith chart. We could use a capacitor as the shunt element, because at y 0.207 lambda away now is equal to 1 minus j1.58. And we need to cancel now a negative j1.58 to get y in equal to 1. To find the capacitance value, if we were to choose this, and you might be doing this in some of your assignments, we need to denormalize the minus J1.58 off of the Smith chart, so we would divide by 70. So Y in is equal to 1 minus J1.58 over 70, and I'm going to just write that as 1 over 70, we're not paying attention to that right now, J.023. So that's the same number, just with a minus sign. And so the shunt admittance we need, and we would have to use a capacitor in this case, so YC, and that is equal to J omega C, because we would want, we would need to now have a positive, so we want that equal to positive J.023. So I can rearrange, I can solve for C, actually that's a little easier here. Then for the inductor, C is just positive J.023 over J omega. And the J's cancel, 2 pi F, plug everything in, and we get 1.22 nanofarads. But again, Chewbacca also doesn't have a capacitor laying around with that exact capacitance. And we don't really want to try to build one necessarily, so the only thing we easily have available to us is this transmission line that we've been using, which we gave earlier as Z0 equals 70. We've used this to connect the generator to the load, and so we have some extra transmission line with the same impedance and admittance laying around. So let's ask ourselves, is there a way we could use the extra transmission line to match the antenna to the transmission line? In other words, we've matched our real part when we go back to this distance D, and now can we use, maybe instead of adding an inductor or a capacitor here at this position D, could we maybe attach another transmission line and put it in parallel with ZL?